वेलकम बैक ऑल ऑफ यू टू आवर ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म दैट इज़ अवर स्कूल्स यूट्यूब चैनल। सो अगेन वी आर रेडी विद टूडेज वीडियो। दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर क्लास 9 एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज मैथ्स एंड वी आर प्रोसीडिंग द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 2 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज पॉलिनोमियल्स। सो वी विल कंटिन्यू द क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 2.2। द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इज गिवन, फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ के, फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ के इफ द कंडीशन इज गिवन, इफ x माइनस 1 इज अ फैक्टर ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल एंड दैट पॉलिनोमियल इज, दैट इज फर्स्ट पार्ट दैट x स्क्वायर प्लस x प्लस k, फर्स्ट पार्ट पी एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स प्लस के, एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स प्लस के। इफ नाउ वी विल सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन, इफ एक्स माइनस वन इज अ फैक्टर ऑफ पी एक्स देन द रिमाइंडर शुड बी जीरो। एंड हाउ टू फाइंड द रिमाइंडर, वी विल नॉट डिवाइड दैट, वी आर सपोज टू यूज दैट रिमाइंडर थ्योरम। मीन्स देन पी ऑफ, इफ एक्स माइनस वन इज ए फैक्टर मीन्स पी ऑफ वन शुड बी जीरो। सो वी विल फाइंड पी ऑफ वन मीन्स पी ऑफ वन शुड बी इक्वल टू जीरो। पी ऑफ वन मीन्स वी आर सपोज टू सब्स्टिट्यूट द एक्स बाय वन मीन्स वन स्क्वायर प्लस वन प्लस के इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो। वन स्क्वायर मीन्स वन प्लस के इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो मीन्स के इक्वल्स टू वन प्लस वन टू। एंड देन व्हेन वी आर सपोज टू ट्रांसफर एनी डिजिट फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड टू द राइट हैंड साइड द साइन विल बी चेंज, सो के इज इक्वल्स टू माइनस टू। सो द मेन थिंग इज दैट इफ वन पॉलिनोमियल इज अ फैक्टर ऑफ द अनदर वन, सपोज हियर एक्स माइनस वन इज अ फैक्टर मीन्स P of 1 should be 0 according to the remainder theorem. At the same time, we will take the part second of this question. Some more parts are there, remaining parts you are supposed to try. And the second part, the polynomial is given, that is 2x square plus kx plus under root 2. 2x square plus kx plus under the root 2. Again we will write, if x minus 1 is a factor of px then p of 1 should be equals to 0. P of 1, again we have to substitute the values 2 into 1 square plus 1 into k plus under the root 2 should be equals to 0. 1 square 1, 2 1 ja 2 plus k plus under the root 2 is equals to 0. From here we can write k is equals to minus 2 minus under the root 2, or we can sort it out, we can take the minus sign common from that and it will become 2 plus under the root 2. Like this we are supposed to find the value of k if one polynomial is given, that is the factor of a given polynomial px. At the same time, now some remaining parts are there, you are supposed to try at home. If any problem is there, then you can message us or you can call us, we will try to rectify. Afterwards we are supposed to move towards the next question, that is question number 4. In question number 4 we are supposed to factorize. I hope that you already know how to factorize. Factorize the following, we will take only one part, and the first part is given, that is 12x square minus 7x plus 1, I think so, that is the question. So such type of questions, what we have to do, we are supposed to find two numbers whose product and sum should be the finite one. Now here, what should be the product? The coefficient of x square and the constant term, means this into this. 12 should be the product and the sum should be the coefficient of x, that is minus 7, not 7. We are supposed to include the minus sign as well, and the product should be minus 7. So such type of numbers are minus 4 and minus 3, because if we sum minus 3 plus minus 4, that becomes minus 7, and if you multiply minus into minus, plus 4, 3 is 12. So we will split the middle term. We are supposed to split that. How to split? We will write 12x square minus 4x minus 3x plus 1. So the first term and the last term, we are not doing anything with that. We are supposed to split this into two parts. Minus 7x has been written as minus 4x minus 3x. This is the only method in which we are this is the only method by which we can split, because if we change minus 7 into two parts, that is minus 6 minus 1, then the product will not be plus 12. So this is a unique one only, that will be the same for all. So afterwards, what we have to do, we have to take common. If anything is common from here, 4 is common, and 4 is common in 12 as well, and x is also common. So we will take 4x common. Common means we are supposed to divide this by 4x. So 4 3 is 12, 3 into x, and from here it will come minus 1. Here nothing is common, so we will take minus 1 common, 3x plus 1. After taking common, if your both the brackets are same, means you are proceeding in a right direction, otherwise no. So 3x minus 1, we have taken common from here, means we are left only with 4x, and from here we are left only with minus 1. So this has been already factorized. So we will take one more part. That is the second part. Second part is 2x square plus 7x plus 3. 2x square plus 7x plus 3. So here the product should be 2, 3 is 6, and the sum should be 7. So like this, both are positive. So 6 we can take 6 and 1. So 6 plus 1, 7, and 6 1 is 6. So we will split again the middle term, 2x square plus 6x plus x plus 3. So look, first term is same, last term is same. The middle term has been split into two parts. 7x has been written into the form of 6x plus x, 7x. So from here we will take 2 common and x common. So 2x, if we have divided this first term by 2x, 2 cancel out 2, x cancel out 1x. So here comes x only, plus here x cancel out x, and 2, 3 is 6. Then from here nothing is common, then 1 will be common always. So here we can see x plus 3 is here, x plus 3 is here. So x plus 3 has been taken as common. So from here only 2x is remaining, and from here plus 1 is remaining. So this has been already factorized. So this is the method, and the name of the method is splitting the middle term. As you have seen, in both the part we have splitted the middle term only, and afterwards we have to search what is common in the two terms. First two terms something will be common, and last two terms something will be common. We are supposed to take that common, and after taking common, we should be careful that the bracket should have the same values. This was question number 4, and now we will move towards question number 5. And the question number 5, again we have to factorize, but here we have to factorize a polynomial with degree 3. So the polynomial is x cube minus x square minus x, and then x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. So as I told you previously that if the degree is 3, there will be 3 values of x for the given polynomial, and we have already factorized the previous in the previous question. If we are supposed to factorize the polynomial with degree 2, there will be 2 brackets, and if we are supposed to factorize the polynomial with degree 3, there will be 3 brackets. So first factor we are supposed to find by hit and trial method, means we are supposed to put the different values of x and we will see whether p of that value is 0 or not. So we will check by putting p, we can take the values of x 0 or plus minus 1 or plus minus 2. So first of all we will find p of 0, that is 0 minus 0 minus 0 plus 2, and that is not equals to 0, means x is not the factor. So then afterwards we will try p of 1. P of 1 means we will substitute x by 1, means 1 cube minus 2 into 1 square minus 1 plus 2, and we will get 1 cube means 1, 2 into 1 minus 2 minus 1 and plus 2, minus 2 cancel out plus 2, minus 1 cancel out plus 1, and that is 0. So here if p of 1 is equals to 0, it implies x minus 1 is a factor of px. P1 is 0, then x minus 1 will be the factor. If p minus 1 would have been 0, then x plus 1 would have been the factor of that given polynomial. Now we got the one factor, so we will divide the given polynomial by that factor, that is x minus 1 is the factor. Now we will divide the given polynomial, that is x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. So you know how to divide the polynomials by polynomial by long division method. So we are supposed to multiply here by x square. So x square into x, x cube, x square minus 1 minus x square, then we are supposed to subtract minus, and we will change the sign, minus 2x square plus x square minus x square, and we will borrow these two terms downwards. Then again we will compare the first term, a minus will be required, and x into x into x, that is x square, so minus x square, minus into minus plus x into minus 1 x, and then nothing is there. Again we are supposed to change the signs. After changing the sign, this will be cancelled out, minus x minus x minus 2x, and then this is plus 2. So again we require minus 2, so minus 2 into x minus 2x, and minus 2 into minus 1, that is plus 2. Again we will get, we are supposed to reverse the signs, and after reversing we will get 0 here. So you have read in your previous classes that dividend is equals to quotient into divisor plus remainder. So we can write, hence we can write, what we can write, that the dividend is x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2, that is p of x is equals to x minus 1 is a divisor, and the quotient is x square minus x minus 2 plus 0, because remainder, so that is of no use. So already one factor we are having, we are supposed to find the factor of this quadratic equation. So how we will find the factors of this quadratic equation? In the previous question, we have tried to find by splitting the middle term. So this will be x minus 1, and here we will split the middle term, means that will be x square minus 2x plus x minus 2, minus 2x plus x minus x. So again that will be same, and here we will take x common, so here will be x minus 2. From here we will take this common. Afterwards I think that will not be visible to you, so we will write on the upper side, and for that we are supposed to erase that. So we can write this, that is the px, p of x is equals to x minus 1, and from here x minus 2 is common, and we are left with x plus 1. So x plus 1, so this is the factorized form of px, where the px was x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2, and as I told you, the degree of the px is 3, so there will be 3 brackets. So like this you are supposed to proceed the questions given in this exercise. I hope that you have understood, and still if you are having any doubt, then you can message us or you can even call us. We will try to rectify your doubts. At the same time, you are supposed to complete, you are supposed to try to solve the questions which we have solved here today as well, plus the questions given in the exercises. And after completing the homework, means the after solving the questions, you are supposed to take the pic of that, and you are supposed to upload on the school's WhatsApp number. Thank you very much.